Welcome everyone to another episode of our UGMP Annex 1 New Draft webinars. Before starting, let me emphasize that this presentation refers to the latest available draft issued by the European Committee, which is not yet released or enforced. This presentation includes our interpretation of the change, which may differ from auditors and regulatory interpretation. Let's have a look at the agenda. First, we will dive into the new requirement of the Annex 1. Then we will evaluate the best approaches and procedures to correctly create environmental trend analysis. And at the end, we will discuss the best practices to define and control alert and action levels. Historically, each publication of Annex 1 introduced a step towards qualitative improvements in the manufacturing of sterile medical products. Annex 1, published in 2009 and currently in effect, is focused on improving the manufacturing processes and on the measurement, keeping them under control. However, something is still missing. To follow the path of scientific methodology, data analysis must be introduced into the regulation. Reading the Annex 1 in depth, data analysis and trending were almost never mentioned. The new draft, finally, address this gap. Trends and data analysis are very important in the new draft and are quoted in every part of the document. With a quick check, you find that trends are now required in several activities, from high-level strategic documentation through machines and processes, from pharmaceutical utilities, such as water for injection, to personal monitoring, and of course, to environmental contamination and related monitorings. The concept of trend is strongly highlighted in the Annex 1 new draft. As a fundamental piece to properly measure and maintain the proper quality level at each stage of the production process. Specifically, the trend evaluation applies to the definition of a contamination control strategy, creation of a monitoring program with user-defined alert and action level, using the result and excursion evaluation to support an investigation and CAPA plan. Differing from the existing Annex 1, the new draft lists the minimum evaluation to take into the account when defining a trending approach in your monitoring procedure. For example, the increasing number of action alert level breaches, consecutive breaches of alert level, regular and isolated breaches with potential common cause, change in microbial flora or predominance of specific microorganisms are just few of the elements to keep under control using a trend evaluation approach. Considering these activities should be performed on a daily or a periodical basis, it is clear how the effort associated with trend evaluation will increase once the new Annex 1 will be released. Fortunately, the market already offers software and system solutions capable of processing huge amounts of data automatically and in compliance with the data integrity rules. So the question is, how can I evaluate all items required by the new Annex, such as trend, frequencies of breaches, etc.? Of course, we should start with evaluation of the qualification data, which represent the base of clean room contamination. Then the continuous monitoring data to understand the performance of your clean room during real activities, with personnel inside and operation running. Alert level should not be considered as dangerous, problematic, or something to avoid, but should be properly configured to prevent adverse situation or to address adverse trend even before problem occurs. Data trend should be evaluated for a short time frame, like the duration of a batch, but also for longer time range, like months, here. The life cycle of alert and action level. Starting from the first box, we have the data collection activities, which should be applied according to the current regulation and internal SOP. After that, the data should be statistically evaluated, perhaps using an appropriate statistical tool, and preferably using a statistician that can highlight potential influencing factor of the data. Once the statistical evaluation is complete, the interpretation of data can be carried out by an expert that will help link the insight from the statistical evaluation to practical application and potential root causes. Finally, you can set up the alert and action level with respect to the ISO 14644-2 that clearly suggests avoiding nuisance alarm, but to focus on being able to promptly detect adverse trend. This is an ongoing cycle that must run indefinitely on a periodical basis to ensure your alert and action level remain appropriate for your clean room. Particle measuring system contamination control advisory team can provide professional support to analyze your data and generate statistical insight. The combination of statistical skills with our expertise in sterile assurance and aseptic manufacturing process will help you identify behavior errors and capture measurement problem or wrong sampling location. Navigate on our website to find the local contact and ask for more information about our contamination control advisory team. And if you're looking for modern tool to help your compliant data collection, make sure you get more information about our state-of-the-art facility monitoring system, Facility Pro, and the unique plug-and-play environmental data management software, Pharma Integrity, both designed to meet current and exceed current and future regulation. Thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned for other updates or navigate to www.pmeasuring.com for more information.